You've applied to Humble, uploaded all the required documents, waited for weeks to hear a decision, and you got in. Congratulations! Now that you've gotten to Humble, you think everything is set? Well, from personal experience, I can tell you, not so much. In this video, I'm going to help you out with everything that you need to do before and after you come to Canada. So first things first, just because you've got an offer letter does not mean your seat is secured yet. You still need to log on to MyHumble and confirm your acceptance. With your offer letter, you should have received an acceptance package. And within this acceptance package, there is a link which will show you how to accept your offer letter. So the second most important step is to apply for your Canadian immigration documents. First and foremost, to study at Humble, you have to have a study permit. And if your program has a mandatory placement, you also need to apply for a co-op work permit. I would recommend that you do both at the same time to save time. Go on to the IRCC website to apply for both. And as always, Karan will upload a link in the description. The next step that you need to take is to pay your tuition fees. As we say, nothing in life comes free, and there's always deadlines to everything. So make sure you check your deadline for fees payment on your offer letter. Some payments take longer than other payments, and you should give yourself some window of time to make those payments. For example, a wire transfer takes up to 10 days to come into Humble's account, so I would not pay on the day of the deadline. If you haven't checked out our video for how to pay, you can click on the link here and find out. So once you arrive in Canada, you definitely want a roof over your head. And if you're not staying with friends or family, you have three main options that you can apply for. The first is living on-campus residence. Next, you can rent an apartment or a house. Or third, you can apply for homestay. If you plan on living on campus, in the residence, I would recommend that you send us your application really quickly because it tends to fill up very fast. If you want to find out more information about living on campus, you can click on the link in the description. If you choose to live on an apartment or a house for rent, like many other Humble students do, the first thing you should check is that how far is it from campus and how long will your commute be? How much is it going to cost you? There's a lot of variables, so you should definitely look into all of those. So your third option is living in a homestay. Homestay is basically a really great option for people who want to improve their English. You would be living with a Canadian family and you would have 2 to 3 meals a day included in the price. If you do want to go for this option, you should contact the homestay services directly. You applied to Humble, uploaded your documents, applied for a study permit, went through your immigration stuff, but now you actually have to come here. So to book your flights, I would definitely look at the orientation dates before you do so. This way, you will be able to attend orientation, have a few days to learn more about the country, and then get into classes. So you'll have two different orientations. The first will be your academic orientation, where you will find out more information about your program and meet your faculty. The second orientation is the international student welcome, and you'll learn more about what it means to be an international student. So it is very important that you register for both and attend them. So next up is your health. It's a very important aspect. You should definitely get a medical checkup before you come to Canada. This way, there's no unexpected expenses and you might be able to get treatment before you come here. You are covered for insurance through your tuition, but that only kicks in on the first day of classes, not from the day you arrive in Canada. If you're planning to arrive in Canada a few days before your classes start, it is very important that you're covered by insurance. So if you like to travel and you wish to drive in Canada, get your driver's license from your country and apply for a Canadian one once you get here. You can also use this driver's license as an ID card to get into clubs and for other important purposes. Next up is our neighbors on the south, the US. If you're planning to visit them while you're in Canada or if you have a connecting flight from the US, you need to apply for a US entry visa. It is easier to apply for that if you're applying for it from your home country as opposed to coming to Canada and then doing it. When you arrive to Canada, make sure that you keep some amount of Canadian cash in hand. This will be important for any emergency situations. If you do bring more than $10,000 though, you will have to report it. So coming to a new country can be quite disorienting. Make sure you do some research on Toronto and the neighboring areas. Talk to someone who's been to Canada or is living here currently. Look at the virtual passport from Humble or look at our YouTube videos. This will help you to orient yourself to coming to a new country. Okay, so it's T-minus 7 days. You're almost ready to come to Canada. Make sure you make some memories before you come here. Spend some time with your family, have some parties, meet with your friends, get some memories to get with you here. So when you feel a little lonely and you're missing home, you have something to look back at. So now it's time to pack your bags and come to Canada. So when you're packing your bags, Try bringing as many clothes as you can so you don't end up spending too much money when you get here.
But don't go buy new stuff, especially winter clothes. It's better to buy them in Canada because they're cheaper here. So we organize trips at the beginning of every semester where we take you to shopping outlets and you'll be able to buy these winter clothes there.
Also consider the airline weight limit on your baggage.
So when you arrive in Canada, either at the airport or your port of entry, you may be asked for documents that you use to apply for your visa. So make sure you have all the documents that you use for your visa application with you at all times. Upon receiving your study permit, make sure you check it before you leave the airport. Make sure your name is correctly spelled, your date of birth is correct, and all other fields are entered correctly. So while you're at school, make sure you put a lot of efforts into your assignments and get the very best that the program has to offer you.
But at the same time, don't forget to experience living in a new country and making friends and learning new things. Make sure you come for all the Humber International trips where you can meet people from 130 different countries.
Thank you for watching this video and don't forget to subscribe to our channel. We have a lot more videos coming up.
So make me laugh. So you've applied to Humber, uploaded all the required... No? You've applied to Humber, uploaded all the required documents. Wait. What? Okay, don't laugh. This is gonna take forever. It's a lot of things to keep in mind. Man, this is more difficult than doing deadlifts. So once you come here, you definitely need a Sorry. So if you're not staying with friends or family, there's three main options that you can apply for. So once you arrive in Canada, you definitely... It's like I've never spoken in English before. Apply for a house for rent. Or apply for homestay. No, I looked away. I always look away the moment I'm nervous. So if you do plan on living on campus in the... This is too much pressure, okay. So your third option is homestay. I completely blanked on what homestay is. The next is to book your flight to get here. Totally messed that up. So you've applied for your study permit. You've come across all the major steps. The next big one is to actually come across here. Oh, that was so bad. So say you arrive like a week before and say something happens. I don't want to say that. That's a little dark. And I forget everything. And the only step that's preventing you from going out of the airport is you... No, it sounds like you're in detention. I should become a stand-up comedian. I think I would do a good job. So once you're in Canada and classes have started, put your best effort forward. Best foot forward. What is best effort forward? Oh my God. See, this is what happens when I try to improvise. I improvise too much. So thank you for listening to me. So thank you for watching this video and letting me talk with you for 3 full minutes. No, it's not 3 minutes. Thanks for watching this videos and make sure you keep The one sentence is all I have to say and I mess it up, of course. Genius. You're gonna have so many bloopers, oh my God. Not looking forward to this video.